like Jake White House, that's cool. Little over there. Beautiful house. More down. But I have 40 years of business experience in Valdosta. And I'm a property owner, a property taxpayer. I've got several pieces of property that I have all the property taxes. Just too much money going out. So I'm for reducing that. My business experience gives me a well-rounded perspective in being a property. I'm also a United States Navy veteran. I spent 6 years in the Naval Air Reserve, finished up in Jacksonville, and was discharged in 1977. What I would like to do is, what I plan to do is to cut physical waste, and I'd like to work closely with the industrial board to give them the tools that they need to bring more industry and business in this county. And also work with the existing industry and business in this county to help them expand. I believe that this is what's going to keep our young people here in Lowndes County, giving them good paying jobs. If we can bring in good industry, large industry with good paying jobs that create rooftops, and when houses start going up, the economic engine just really gets to rolling. So that's my spiel on the tax situation. I want to fill up our industrial. We've got 500 acres of available industrial park land. Superstructures there, pavement, water, sewer, ready to go. So we all need to work together, the city, the county, to attract industry, get this going. I support all businesses, small business and large business. And I think a problem, which I'm hearing from knocking on these doors, and I hadn't caught up with Tom yet. My fingers are sore. I'm only about 3,000 houses. I'll catch you by the time I'm moving. I did stop by Country Cobbler 2 weeks ago and bought me an expensive pair of shoes to help on his walking. Tom, you remember walking Boldwood Valley in those hills? That was like being in North Georgia in the mountains. What I'm hearing from people about business is that it's hard to get a business going in Lowndes County. There's too much red tape. You have to fight your way through permits, zoning, and these kinds of things. And I think that ought to be real easy and real simple. I think the zoning people and the permit people and the inspection people ought to be able to sit at a table and come up with a solution instead of making it hard and difficult and make all these demands. You got to do this. You got to do it that way. If we be hard-nosed all the time, then we won't grow. People will go to Brooks County, Lanier County, Cook County, Tipton, wherever. On top of that, we should prepare now for what's to come, for our future. And Tom mentioned infrastructure. The county's in pretty good shape with sewer and water. The city of Valdosta's got the sewage coming up. They're sitting on a 40, 50-year-old or longer antiquated sewer system. And I believe it's going to cost them about $55 million to retrofit all that. Of course, when the time comes, it may be 60 or 75. Cost overruns and stuff like that. But the county has stayed on top of our sewage plants, water. We've recently are putting new equipment in at Lake Lackawanna and another water plant on Beams Road. greater parts per million than the one on Venus. But we'll do them both and eliminate that problem and prepare for the future. We're the 27th largest county in the state of Georgia. And we're the 21st most populous county. Our population is currently 117,000. And we're projected to be 160,000 in 2030. That's 15 years. That's nothing. I mean, I remember back 15 years ago and think, I think that got here. So we have to get our infrastructure set. We have to be ready for this growth. If we don't, then we're going to wake up and we're going to be like the city of Valdosta. And that is really going to slow us down. As Tom mentioned, if we have all these bad articles in the newspaper about our infrastructure, our water problems, our sewer problems, then that's going to fail business in this country. I'll use my business experience to help manage $112 million budget. I believe that you can cut, you can find ways to cut. And I believe if you just keep doing a budget over and over, pretty much the same thing. Call your department heads in. What's your budget going to be? And they don't really put enough effort in it. You got to look in the trash can to see what's being wasted. You got to look on the storage shelf to see what's got dust on it. And don't keep those things around. You got to look at time cards. If they're using time cards now, and see where the hours are going, who's working and who's not working. These kinds of things will make great strides in reducing that wasteful spending. Probably the one thing that I've heard the most about is the trash situation. And I would like to see some of these bulk trash areas open back up. Somewhere where people can take a mattress from a old chest or drawer or a refrigerator or something and dispose of it instead of sitting out in front of their house, calling the collection company to come make an appointment. And they show up 3 weeks later and get I'm a member of a hunting club out on Lower Grand Bay Road on Howell Road. And we had mattresses show up out there. Old broken down furniture and stuff like that. Just a few weeks ago, there were two mattresses out there on the side of the road. Nobody came to mess with them. After about 3 weeks, one of them went missing. Thank God somebody came around and got them a mattress. But we can do better than that. We're a big enough county where we can do a lot better than that. I'd also like to revisit this residential trash situation. We've got two collectors, we've got Deep South, which I don't know about, which I'm just tickled with. And I pay them more than I would pay Advance. Advance is the big company. But I want to revisit that and see if there's some way that we can work that out so that they can both be here. And we'll have a choice as to who we want to pay to pick up our trash and provide that service. And like Tom, I think it's very important to protect our property rights. Yesterday I was out on Phillips Road, which is in the lower west end of the county, and that pipeline is going to cut across a little peninsula of Lowndes County. Not much area, but the fellow I was visiting with, we were sitting on his back porch, and I said, "Eli, where is this pipeline coming?" He said, "Right over there by that fence, 30 feet out in that pasture." And it was probably to his house from here to Tom's balloons back there, to his back porch. I don't like that. There may not be nothing we can do about that. It's federal. Natural Gas Act, Federal Energy Regulation Commission. They have the power of eminent domain. So you know what that 5 feet instead of 3 feet. When they leave a resident's property, there's not some big old ugly footprint out there. They leave that man's property, he can go out there and mow grass. He don't have to go out there level and go behind them and clean things up. And that's the Sable Trail gas line that Tom was talking about. We're very strategically located in this state. Mid-state, I-75 splits us. We have Highway 84 and 122 going east and west. And those are under construction now to be completely four-lane from here to Colquitt and from here to Waycross. That's going to give us even more transportation benefits for like more distribution centers and stuff like that. We have educational facilities that are excellent. As a matter of fact, I graduated from Valdosta State College. Not Valdosta State, New Brunswick. And I think that our educational facilities will provide our young folks with all the opportunities they need to better themselves, to hopefully take the good paying jobs that are coming to Lawrence County so they can stay here. We're 75 miles from the Gulf, 100 miles to the Atlantic. Yeah, these people love good to be here. So that's another strategic part of location when you talk about playtime. Lastly, Moody Air Force Base is very important to this state and this county. There's thousands of people out there that are affected and work and affected by the Air Force Base. And the city, the county, municipalities, we all need to work to keep that base safe and open and secure for our future. So, we all work together. We can make Lowndes County one of the best counties, if not the best county in the state. And my vision